It's getting harder to separate truth from fiction in the age of fake news, with conspiracy theories and propaganda are as old as society itself. Perhaps most disturbing of all is the growing wealth of scientific evidence suggesting that we're influenced even by news we know to be fake, and that's to say nothing of more modern conspiracy theories driven by social media, making unfounded claims about everything from diets to money to the state of reality itself. Here are 5 conspiracy theories which turned out to be true. Please be sure to subscribe, like and share this video with your friends or family. Also turn on the notification to stay tuned to our daily new episodes. The CIA funded the Dalai Lama. Who doesn't love the Dalai Lama? I mean, other than the Chinese government, even the CIA can't get enough of His Holiness and his band of Tibetan resistance fighters. That's because during the 1960s, the CIA allegedly funneled millions of dollars to the Tibetan resistance, including what some claim was a 6-figure annual salary that went directly to the Dalai Lama himself, which he denied in declassified State Department memos. The organization says the purpose of the program is to keep the political concept of an autonomous Tibet alive within Tibet and among foreign nations, principally India, and to build a capability for resistance against possible political developments inside communist China. A secretive cult-like gathering of world elites, a secretive organization of people that control the world. Well, it turns out it does exist, and many of its members are powerful world leaders and titans of industry. The real action happens at Bohemian Grove, which appears to primarily exist as a place where the rich and powerful go to misbehave, according to the Washington Post, or alternatively, to hear it from the group directly, where members share a passion for the outdoors, music, and theater. Owners of the property host a 2-week retreat in California each year for some of the wealthiest and most influential Americans. Past attendees include Richard Nixon and Ronald Reagan, both of whom attended before entering the White House. Oh, and its weather idea for the atomic bomb was first sketched out, no big deal. The Gulf of Tonkin incident in August 2, 1964, the Rusk Maddox opened fire on what it later claimed were several North Vietnamese targets. The skirmish deepened America's involvement in the Vietnam War, leading to the death of thousands of US soldiers and many more Vietnamese, including hundreds of thousands of civilians. Except, it turned out the targets the Maddox fired upon didn't actually exist. It's still debated today whether the incident was an intentional misdirection by the military, but one thing is certain. President Johnson's original claim that the North Vietnamese fired first has been debunked. Even former Defense Secretary Robert McNamara admitted as much in an interview before his death. After all, it's kind of hard to start a fight when you're not even there. MKUltra. Back in the 1950s, the CIA secretly dosed individuals with LSD in order to test the potential effects of mind control, although the practice reportedly continued for 2 decades. It was launched before the drug movement of the 1960s made LSD into a popular counterculture symbol, and while being given some free acid might sound like a great time to some, or at least the plot to a bad hipster action movie, dozens of people were reportedly left with permanent disabilities after secretly being subjected to massive amounts of LSD and electroshock therapy after seeking treatment for minor psychiatric complaints. Gaeta. Who doesn't love Canada? Well, 1960 Canada wasn't quite the squishy utopia it seems to be today. The Canadian government hired Carleton University professor Frank Robert Wake to create something it maliciously called the Fruit Machine, which they believed could detect and identify gay men. It wasn't part of some benign effort to understand human sexuality, it was part of a sick bit of McCarthyism with the stated goal of getting all gay men out of the country's government. More than 400 people lost their jobs, and 9,000 more were kept on a file of suspects. The device claimed to work by measuring how much a subject's pupils dilated after being forced to look at same-sex erotic imagery.